Okay, if you're gonna force me.
No one's forcing you. You can stop anytime.
So, Robert, your latest book's on top of the bestseller list, huh?
It's creeping up there.
Yeah.
My agent's really been pushing it. But little Sully here could care less about bestsellers.
Oh, maybe she doesn't read your books, but the rest of us do.
And I thank you.
Seriously, those books have helped Julie and I manage our money. You should be proud.
To Robert, America's next financial guru.
All right. So, Robert, pretty soon you're going to have your own TV show, syndicated radio program.
No chance of that. Nothing's going to pull me away from my family.
Hey, where did Sarah run off to?
I haven't seen her since we sang Happy Birthday. I can't keep track of her. She's always running around. She's probably digging in her garden.
Well, that's what you get for marrying a girl off the farm.
It's working out pretty well for me so far.
Hey, let's take the boat out.
What is she doing?
I think she wants to take the boat out.
The dock is rotten. We're hoping to have it fixed by next week. Honey, get off the dock.
You can hardly wait for that baby brother, huh?
I'm more excited about the baby than she is.
That's because you don't have to carry the little monster around for the next 9 months.
Captain Robert Benson, you, boat, now.
Looks like I'm going to have to run down there and pull her off that dock myself.
Yep.
Captain Robert Benson, I am getting in this boat.
Sarah, breathe. Sarah. 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 Please. Please, Sarah.
Hello, Devi. How's New York?
It's not as healthy as Storm Lake. Everything okay?
Well, I'm gonna be late on the pages. It'll take me a couple more days. Also, I want to cut the fourth chapter. I read it last night. I think it's unnecessary.
I'll pass it along to the publisher. Very excited about the book, Robert.
I think I can help a lot of people with this one.
Ever the Crusader. Is everything okay otherwise?
Meaning?
Meaning, I am your oldest friend, Robert.
Clean and sober, Deb. I'll have the new draft in a couple of days.
Love you.
Love you.
You're gonna love it. Can't even tell it's organic.
We love the cookies he made last week.
Oh, thanks. Maybe I'll make them next week.
He doesn't believe they're sugarless.
Well, technically he's right. I mean, I use honey, but it's my own honey. So there's no refined sugars in there, I promise.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Okay, I'm gonna start packing up.
Thanks, Charlie. I think we did really well this week.
Yeah, all the gluten-free stuff went fast. Either this town's getting hip or it actually tastes good.
Or maybe both.
Mm-mm. This town is not hip.
Mommy!
Hi!
Are you done yet?
Almost. Why?
You know why. My party.
Party? Is it your birthday?
Come on.
Do you want to see one of your presents now?
Can I? A bike, my own bike!
With tassels and everything.
I thought we said we'd wait another year.
I know, but all of her friends have bikes and I couldn't resist.
But we've talked about this. You know exactly what happens to her blood sugar.
Robert,
level.
It's your birthday.
Daddy, isn't it the coolest?
It's the coolest. Those training wheels aren't coming off till you graduate college, though.
Dad, I'll be an old lady.
Hi, Mr. Benson.
Hey, Charlie. How'd our local farmers do today?
I don't know about these other hicks, but we killed it.
Yeah, we almost sold out of all the pies, and I sold all my honey.
It's amazing. Yeah. Do you need any help?
No, I've got Charlie. It's okay. You can take her back, get her ready for the party. I'm sorry about the bike. I really couldn't help it, and we have to trust her at some point.
You're right. Kids have bikes. All right, Sully, let's get ready for your party.
And don't worry, I got her a helmet, knee pads. I also got her a suit of armor.
Ha, ha, ha. Very funny.
Bye.
Bye.
Guys, slow down! Slow down, no running!
The more they run around, the better they sleep.
I'm gonna be the one that needs to sleep.
Well, you can't stop them anyway, so live and let live, I say.
Yeah, tell that to Robert. I'm telling you, Julia, he babies that girl way more than I do. He checks her blood sugar, like, every 5 minutes and doesn't even trust the test.
Well, he's just scared, that's all.
Yeah, but I don't know, something's different.
Jerry said he stopped drinking.
Yeah, no, yeah, he did. I don't know what he did, but he hasn't had a drink in, like, 6 months.
Good for him.
Yeah. I think it's the day, too. You know, he remembers the accident and still can't forgive himself.
That was 5 years ago.
Believe me, I've moved on, but no, he's just not there yet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, how's the baby search going?
Sarah? Get out here. Someone's about to open their presents without you.
We'll be there in a minute. Actually, the agency called, and they have a new birth mother they want us to meet.
The robbers hated them all, right?
Yeah. I mean, I haven't been too crazy about any of them either, but I don't know, apparently this woman is really just jumping at the chance to meet us, so...
Well, maybe she's the one.
I hope so. I really think another baby will bring the old Robert back.
I remember that guy. He used to dance around this kitchen to corny old music.
Yeah. Seems like a million years ago. Well, we pulled that off. Another year.
All those kids. She never stopped running around. No wonder she passed out like a log.
A happy log. You seem distracted.
Oh, it's this deadline. I have to get the book to the publisher by the end of the month.
So it's just the book, then?
Okay, Sarah. You know it's the day. It always has this effect on me.
Yeah, but maybe every year it gets a little easier.
That's just it. I think it's actually getting worse. I can still picture the accident like it was yesterday. You should... I knew the dock was rotten.
Robert, stop beating yourself up. You know what happens.
I'm trying.
I believe you. It's not just you I'm thinking about.
Don't you think I know? It's Sully. I can't stop worrying about her. The diabetes. Did she eat too much cake when I wasn't looking? Is she too active? It's driving me insane.
Well, hopefully you'll like this birth mother tomorrow. I think having a second baby around here will really, you know, restore the balance.
I know.
And we've tried everything. You know, I can't have children.
You're right. I think it's the day that this book, it's just all too much stress.
Well, you know, I know an old-fashioned remedy for stress.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Old family secret?
Oh, yeah, it's been in the family for years.
I'm all yours, Doctor.
Hi, welcome. Don't mind me, I was just watering.
This is Bridget.
Hello. I thought houses like this only existed in the movies.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, we're really proud of it.
Come on in.
Is Robert here?
Yeah, we're expecting both of you. Can I get you anything?
Coffee for me.
My husband should be down in a second.
Here we go. Thank you.
You sure I can't get you anything?
Yeah, I just had a shake and some fries before I got here. Your daughter?
Yeah, Sully. She's our world.
She's beautiful.
Oh, thanks. You like children?
Oh, yes. One day I want to have a really big family. I mean, when I'm ready.
Yes, of course.
Hello, everyone.
Robert, this is Bridget.
Bridget.
Bridget Gibson.
Hello.
Hi. Oh, look what I did.
It's quite right.
No, I'll get it. I'll go get a broom.
No, please, I don't want you to cut yourself. It's fine.
I'm so sorry, sir.
No, please, call me Robert. Please, sit down. So, tell us about yourself.
Right now I live in Idaho Falls. I was going to college, but I ended up dropping out because I couldn't afford it. I was gonna take out one of those student loans, but I really hate being in debt.
Sounds like you read one of my husband's books. People who read his books are afraid of being in debt.
That's not true. Well, my books preach fiscal responsibility, that's all.
I did. Read one of your books, Mr. Benson. Debt, not just a four-letter word.
Yes, of course.
I'm actually a really big fan.
See, what'd I tell you?
Very smart.
I'm just trying to save up my money so that I can get out of my current living situation.
What is your current living situation?
I'm in a shelter. It's okay, though.
Just okay?
I mean, the food isn't that great, and I don't sleep that well. I do worry about this little guy, though.
How so?
I mean, it would probably be better if I could rest a little more, you know?
So you say it's a boy?
A boy.
How far along are you?
6 months.
Is it hard?
Well, you know, in the beginning, there was morning sickness and... I know why you wanted to meet me. And any parent adopting a child would. I'm the same. When I got a call from the agency saying they had found a couple, I just wanted to be sure. I love my baby, and If I could afford to live in a house like this and give him a life like you two could. I know in my heart what I'm doing is right.
So the agency will contact you both if it's a fit and if Bridget agrees. Fingers crossed, but it looks positive.
Daddy, look what I can do.
Where's your helmet?
I'm so sorry. I'm really overprotective when it comes to kids.
Well, don't be sorry, Miss Gibson. Sully.
I don't like it on my head.
Oh, here, let me. Let's keep that head of yours safe so you grow up smart like your mom and dad. Is she gonna be okay in that shelter?
It really is the best place for her.
I'm ahead of my wife on this one. What if she were to stay with us? People do that, right?
Well, yes, it's done all the time, but you should take time and think about it.
What do you think about that, Bridget?
I wasn't paying attention.
Well, if we were to decide to go through with it, would you be comfortable living here with us?
We'd make it very comfortable for you. I wouldn't want to bother you guys.
Well, why don't you think about it?
So? Are you gonna say anything?
About what?
You know about what.
I like her. I liked her a lot. It's just a big decision. Sarah, it's just, we don't even know if she's gonna like us.
Robert, you're just scared. Besides, what's not to like about us?
Well, if she's read one of my books, she can't be that bad.
I think we're gonna be very happy.
Heavy lifting for you. Give me those.
I'm okay.
Oh, you better listen to him. He's not gonna let you out of his sight for the next 3 months. And finally, this is your room. Hope you like it. Bathroom's in there, and extra towels, I think, are in here. So it's nice. It's so big. Oh, thanks. Robert and I added it on when we thought we were having a second child. I guess maybe I never stopped believing that this would be a baby's room again. Well, now it will be. Thank you. I can't tell you how much this means to me and my family.
Hey, you.
Hey, Mommy.
You remember Sully.
Of course. How's the bike riding going?
Okay. My dad wouldn't take off my training wheels.
My daddy wouldn't either, but I'm sure he'll come around.
Yeah, don't be so sure.
Is that a baby in there?
Yeah, it's your baby brother. Do you want to feel? Okay, maybe next time. I don't feel him kicking now anyways.
All right, well, let's check your pump and get you some breakfast.
Okay.
Can I get you anything?
I could go for a giant bowl of ice cream.
You know, sorry, we don't keep a lot of sugary things in the house because of her. She's diabetic, but I'm sure I can find you something.
Actually, I'm good.
Okay. Yeah, just to warn you, I'm one of those organic food people. What can I say? Ooh, are you okay?
Yeah, I just, I think I need to rest.
Oh, okay.
Hello?
Oh, we're in the guest room. Charlie helps me at the farm stand. You'll love him.
Bridget, thank God you're finally here. Maybe the boss lady will relax a little.
Yeah, don't count on it. Did you see how many orders of pumpkin bread we got?
Work, work, work. If I didn't love her so much, I'd kill her.
Okay, we're gonna leave you alone.
Great meeting you. You'll be seeing too much of me around here.
And you'll be seeing way too much of me.
I like her.
All right, we're suffocating you now. Okay, bye.
Robert, what a mess.
So I was thinking of having Sally help me out at the farm stand today. Get her out of your hair and let you write in peace.
That would be great. I could use the peace and quiet.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning. I don't usually sleep in this late.
Oh, you can sleep as late as you want. I'm sure you're really tired from yesterday.
Oh, I was out like a light. That bed is so comfortable. It's so peaceful here.
So what can we get you?
Oh, don't bother. I don't really eat breakfast.
Nothing? I can't make you some eggs, hot cereal, anything?
Some coffee, but I'm not really hungry.
You have to eat for the baby as well.
You better listen to her. She's bossier than her mother.
Okay, you win. What should I have?
Cereal. I bet cereal's good for babies.
Okay, cereal it is.
Don't indulge her. You'll never hear the end of it. She'll give you more advice than a pediatrician.
So Sully and I are gonna go into town today. I have a farm stand there. Do you wanna go into town with us?
You should come. You work at the stands like me.
Ladies, let the girl rest. How about this? We'll come into town later for lunch.
That's a good idea. Meanwhile, you can get settled.
Oh, yeah, I think that'd be better. Plus, I saw you guys have a doc out there. I'd love to go down there and read.
The doc is off limits. It's too dangerous.
All right, well, we should get going. Charlie likes to have help setting up. Let's get your coloring books.
Stay close to your mother. Don't forget your emergency snack.
Okay. Bye, Bridget.
Bye, Sully. Hey, thanks for the advice.
So what did the publisher say?
They're fine with cutting that chapter, Robert, but they're hoping for a late fall release.
I know. I'm working as fast as I can, Deb.
It's not why I called you, Robert, and you know it.
The answer is no.
Robert, we sell twice as many of your books if you do a book tour.
I make enough, okay? And I've said it a billion times. No more book tours. Those days are over.
Why do you hate your readers?
I love my readers. I just don't have the stamina to go on the road again, especially after last time.
Oh, come on, Robert. You're not fooling me. No one partied as hard as you did on the road.
Is that what that was, partying? I believe they have a clinical name for it. If you recall, I blacked out last time.
Fine, so lay off the booze, but you still have groupies and they want to see you.
Debbie.
Fine, I'm done. I will wait for the pages. They want a corrected proof in a month.
Don't remind me. Bye, Deb.
Bye. Love you.
Come in.
I'm so sorry to bother you. I was going to sit out on the patio in the sun. And I was wondering if you had any sunblock in the house.
Sunblock? Yeah.
Oh, I did it. I'm totally bothering you.
No. No, no. It's just when I come in here, I go to a different place.
That's all.
The life of a writer. Wow. It must get hard, Robert.
Hard? It is sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Alone, all the time.
Sunblock. Follow me. Well, I know she keeps bug spray in here, so I'm assuming we'll find sunblock. Honestly, I could get rid of half this stuff. I don't think anyone would notice.
Well, I found a box of Christmas lights.
Perfect. Well, if you need gardening gloves, there's a whole bag over here.
Oh, there's more stuff in here than my last apartment.
You see, bug spray, it should be close by.
Oh, here's bug spray.
Okay, it should be right by the bug spray.
I don't see it.
Ah, sunscreen.
Awesome.
SPF 30, is that enough?
Yeah, that'll do.
Well, if you need anything else, batteries, lighter fluid, it should all be in here.
I'll keep that in mind.
Coffee.
Oh, you're a lifesaver. Gosh, we had a pretty good crowd this morning.
Yeah, best little farm stand in Storm Lake.
Hey, Robert's bringing Bridget into town for lunch.
So, what's she like?
She's quiet. You know, I think she's getting used to us.
And you just leave her alone in the house with Robert?
She's 6 months pregnant.
Some men like that.
How would you know?
Look, gay people live in the same world as everyone else.
She's not his type.
Oh, you're right. Men hate gorgeous women. No wonder she got knocked up.
Charlie! I feel sorry for her, poor girl.
Look, you're doing a beautiful thing. Knowing Robert, he's probably hiding in his attic, too afraid to even talk to her.
We should get going if you want to do lunch in town.
I keep falling asleep.
Well, we don't have to go. I could make you some lunch here.
Yeah, I think that might be better. I don't know if I'm feeling up for it.
I'll just text Sarah and let her know.
She won't be disappointed, will she?
Sarah? No. She never stops working, and that's the way she likes it.
Bridget! Hey. Hi. Charlie. Sarah and Robert's friend.
Oh my God, I'm so sorry. I was on the phone and my mind was a million miles away.
Yeah, don't stress about it. I'm completely forgettable. You getting your morning fix?
Yeah, I don't operate without my coffee.
Same. So how's life cooped up in the Benson mansion?
I love it. Robert is so nice.
Listen, you should really be careful. Robert has a really violent temper. And the police in this town have a 24-hour surveillance on him.
For what?
I'm totally kidding. He's like the nicest man in the world. Maybe a little reserved, but everyone has their demons, right?
Yeah, I guess.
Can I feel? Oh.
Sorry,
no,
I'm sorry. No, I'm sorry. It's totally fine. It just makes me uncomfortable.
Yeah, of course it would. And strangers coming up to you feeling your belly? It's weird.
Miss, large latte?
Yeah.
Charlie, leave my customers alone.
Oh, don't get on her bad side. She'll spit in your coffee.
Well, it was nice seeing you.
Yeah.
I'm sure I'll see you around.
Can't be avoided.
So, Bridget, you've been here for a few days. What do you think of our little town?
It's like a little dream town. Everyone is so friendly. I feel like I could live here.
We like it.
I had coffee at the little cafe in town, and then I went into some shops.
It's tourist season right now. People come here for the lake. Robert hates them, but I kind of like it when the town picks up.
I don't hate them. I just don't like the big motors on the lake. It's too loud.
Robert's trying to regulate the size of the motor you can have on the lake. It's a political thing, and if you're not on Robert's side, you're an idiot.
Well, they are idiots. I'm trying to help them save their town.
See, I think I prefer peace and quiet, too. I had this boyfriend once who had a really big, loud boat, and every weekend we'd go up to this lake by us, and he'd make me sit on the front in a bikini just to show me off. I knew how to pick him.
So you ran into Charlie today?
Yes, I did.
He's the best. He's been working for me for about 4 years. I used to sell organic fruits and vegetables out of the back of my truck, and Charlie was the one that got me thinking bigger.
Sarah's about to open 2 new stands in nearby towns.
Yeah.
If this continues, I may be able to retire.
What would you do if you could retire?
Exactly what I'm doing now. I'd write and make sure this little girl has everything she needs.
Don't forget about my new baby brother.
You're right. Sarah can work, and I'll stay at home with the 2 kids.
That sounds perfect. Can I say something? When I first got here, I guess I was a little scared. Because this is a really big decision. But you guys are so nice. And you really do have the perfect life. I know my baby couldn't be in a happier place. I can't tell you how happy you've made us. And you're gonna have a perfect life too one day, I promise. I hope it's in a town like this with a family like yours.
No more train wheels. Are you ready?
You bet. You right there? Right there?
Yep. All right. I'm gonna hold you to start. All right, I'm gonna let go. And 1, 2, 3. Okay, don't get too close to the road. Dwayne.
So, girls gotta be more careful, huh?
What are you doing here?
Oh, you know, I'm just checking up on my 2 favorite babes. It's a nice house.
Yeah, well, you can't be here. I told you to wait for me at the cabin.
Hey there, little girl. What's your name, huh?
Dwayne, cut it out. You have to go.
Okay.
Now.
I'll see you soon.
Go.
It's nice meeting you.
Do you know that man?
Sort of.
He scared me.
I know, but he's gone now. Men like that? You gotta be careful, Sully. Most of them just want to use you.
Did you see? I ruined my bike without the training wheels.
I did, yeah. But listen, if your daddy caught you, he would not be happy. So, how about we just make this our little secret for a while, okay?
I didn't want to show him.
I know, but if he finds out you took the training wheels off, he might take your bike away.
He will?
Mm-hmm. So, don't tell anybody about the training wheels or the man that was just here, okay?
Okay, but you can't tell anyone either.
Cross my heart.
Coffee break in 10 minutes.
Yeah, can we make it 5?
Hey, how's Bridget working out?
She's really great. She and Sully are practically best friends.
What does Robert think?
I don't know. He's been kind of a little shut down lately.
What do you mean?
It's like he's afraid or something.
Afraid of what?
Oh, everything. Life, having fun, Sully. He worries about her so much, I don't know what to do.
Well, maybe you should see a therapist.
Yeah, you know Robert, he thinks therapists are for sick people.
Typical.
I don't know, I really thought bringing Bridget into the house and adopting this baby would sort of pull him out of it, you know, but it's almost like it's made it worse.
Even I've noticed that Robert's been a little off lately. Is everything okay?
Yeah, I think he's just stressed. Yeah, and once we have the baby, I feel like we'll all find some peace.
Is that how it works?
Yeah, all right, go get your coffee, smartass. Hello.
You startled me. I was daydreaming. I do that a lot.
Wishing you were on the lake?
Gosh, no. Oh, sit. The truth is, I'm actually afraid to get on the water.
Afraid?
Some years ago, Sarah had an accident.
Accident?
The dock broke. She hit her head and fell in the water. She was 6 months pregnant. We lost the child.
You must have been so tortured.
Worst part is, I blame her. I know it was an accident. If she just hadn't acted so foolishly.
Yeah.
I just can't seem to get past that. Sometimes I think I may never love her the way I used to. It's funny. I've never told anyone that before.
Well, maybe you feel safe around me.
Maybe.
Robert, are you happy?
Happy? I'm not really sure. Sometimes I am, I guess. What about you? Are you happy?
I think soon I'll be very happy.
You really are a strange girl.
Hey, Charlie!
Good morning. Coffee for me, decaf for Sarah.
Got it. How's work today? Charlie, your coffees?
Oh.
You haven't turned the page in 5 minutes. Is everything okay?
Everything's fine.
Okay.
I was in the pantry today, and I found an unopened box of chocolates.
It was probably a gift or something.
Come on, Sarah. If Sully were to find that, you know exactly what would happen.
Robert, what is going on?
You know the dangers of diabetic ketoacidosis.
And Sully knows not to eat candy unless we say it's okay. You have to trust her.
She's 6.
I cannot take this anymore. Robert, with all of this worrying. Ever since you got back from your last book tour, you have been completely shut down. It is suffocating. I've noticed it. Sully's noticed it. Even Charlie said something to me about it.
What is going on?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
What's that?
This? It's nothing.
Why do you wear that?
Look, I have to tell you something, but it needs to be our little secret.
Okay.
So some women, when they get pregnant, they have big bellies, and some don't. I have a small belly.
Then why do you have that pretend one?
Because if I didn't, your parents might not believe that I have a baby. And I do have a baby.
I could tell them.
No, 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 no. It's gonna be just between us, okay? Just like your training wheels. You don't want your dad to take your bike away, right?
No.
So that's why you can't say anything. Or something really bad is going to happen. Can you promise?
Thank you,
hey, I have an idea.
Oh, I just got a text from Bridget.
Sarah asked me to take Sully to the farm stand.
She did?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We'll see you at dinner?
Yep. We'll see you at dinner.
Bridget? Joni, don't stop daring.
Joni Mathers, I have 7 minutes.
Back here. It'll be our little secret.
Sully. Sarah?
Robert, what are you doing here?
Sully. Where's Sully?
She's with Bridget at the park. She said you said it was okay.
I'll be at the park, okay?
Is everything okay?
And where were you, Mr. Benson?
Here, in my house. Sheriff, why aren't we out there looking for her?
You were in the house. Well, what made you go out looking for your daughter, Miss Benson?
No reason. I'm just very protective of her.
It's not unusual, officer. He gets very worried.
Because of her medical condition?
Yes.
Sheriff, have you issued some sort of alert? Are you putting up a roadblock? Are you organizing any sort of search party?
We have people working on this, I can assure you. I just want to get a clearer picture of this woman, Bridget Gibson.
That may not even be her real name.
I'm sorry, dude. Know something?
What? No. What is there to know? She's taken our child.
She's pregnant, and we're adopting her baby. We actually know very little about her. She seems very nice. I'm sure this is just a misunderstanding.
We're wasting time, okay? Our child has been taken from us. She's out there. She's sick, and she's scared.
Is there any reason at all for you to think of for Miss Gibson to want to take your child?
No. She seems to like us very much. We like her. No.
Miss Benson.
Huh?
Any reason she might want to take Sully?
No, I can't think of any. Look, I'm tired of sitting around here. I'm gonna go look for her myself.
Chief, we got a picture from the agency.
Okay, great. Let's get that out there, pass it along to the state. This is a current picture?
No, that's not her.
That's the wrong photograph. That isn't Bridget Gibson.
We double checked. That's Bridget Gibson.
Is there any possibility that the woman who's been living here is not Bridget Gibson?
We should be long gone.
Everyone's gonna think we're halfway out of the state by now.
I don't know. Why are we still in the area? I mean, we should be on our way to Kansas City or something right now.
Just stop worrying, okay?
I feel a lot safer in a bigger city.
It's okay. No one is gonna be looking for us on this side of the lake. So we stick to the plan.
What are you gonna say to her when she wakes up?
Leave it to me. Yeah?
Hey.
Mm-hmm.
How rich are they, huh?
We will be getting crazy money.
Then we're out of here, right?
Yeah, just the way we planned it.
Hey, you don't think they're looking for us, right?
They don't even know you exist. Oh, I can't wait to change.
I don't know. Kind of liked you with the big belly.
Please.
Just saying.
Don't start.
This is ridiculous.
Robert, please don't.
Sarah, come on, one drink. I'm going crazy. We can't just sit here.
There's nothing we can do.
Well, what are you doing?
I'm making a flyer. I couldn't think of anything else. I don't know. I'm gonna put them everywhere tomorrow.
I let you down. I let everybody down.
Robert, please don't be so hard on yourself. It's not helpful.
You don't understand, Sarah. I know her.
What?
think I know her. Bridget was on a book tour, the last one. When we lost the baby, I went crazy. I said yes to every book tour. I think it was a way for me to get rid of the memory. And I drank. I drank every night out on the road. Because I hated myself. I hated everything. The accident. It was like I was trying to kill myself. And I hated you for falling that day.
Robert.
I slept with her.
You slept with Bridget?
I was drunk. I was wrong. I don't know what made me do it. This morning, I went into her room. I knew something wasn't right. I found my book. Inside, I'd written a note to some girl named Joni, and all of a sudden, it came flooding back.
I don't understand.
The picture the sheriff showed us is probably the real Bridget. The girl who's been living with us is named Joni.
What does she want with us? Why did she steal Sully?
I don't know. Revenge?
How could you do this?
I don't have an answer. I was lost.
Why didn't you just talk to me? Don't I matter?
Sarah, I did something that I can never take back, and it consumes me every day. I know you hate me, but I hate myself more.
If you think I hate you for cheating on me, you underestimate me. I hate you for endangering our child. My baby is out there without her medicine with a crazy woman. Because of you, you did this. How could you do this to our family?
Hey, baby, how you feeling?
Your hair. You look different.
Do you like it? I changed it. Girls do that all the time.
Where am I?
We're at my friend's house. We had so much fun last night. Do you remember?
Where's Mommy and Daddy?
They had an emergency, so they asked me to watch you.
What kind of emergency?
Their friend is sick and he's in the hospital. So they're gonna be gone for a few days.
Shouldn't we go home and wait for them?
No. I thought that you and I could play house here. Me and you all day. Doesn't that sound fun?
My tummy hurts.
Yeah? Okay, I'm gonna go get you something for your tummy. You just stay here, okay?
Okay.
I messed up.
Wow, what's going on?
I should have grabbed your medicine for her pump before I left the
house. Oh, I can go get some medicine.
No, that's not gonna work. It's prescription, dummy.
Well, what's she got?
She's some kind of diabetic.
Oh, hell, my brother had that. Yeah, it's low blood sugar. You just give him a couple candy bars and he'll be good to go.
She doesn't look too good.
Huh. Well, seeing as how you can't go into town, I guess I'll have to go get us some candy.
Thank you.
Then in the meantime, you call that daddy of hers and tell him his little girl is sick and needs his help, yeah?
Oh, and tell him to get his money, too, yeah?
So you saw this girl, Bridget, get out of a truck. What kind of truck?
Just a regular pickup truck.
What make?
I don't know. Older? Not too old. It was green and white.
You got a license plate number?
No. It happened really fast.
All right, tell me about the guy.
He was scruffy, you know, had a 5 o'clock shadow. He He was wearing jeans, maybe cowboy boots. He was kind of handsome in that redneck kind of way. He was young, about her age. She definitely knew him.
Why didn't you tell the Bensons you saw Bridget with a strange man?
Robert, Mr. Benson, would have freaked out. He's a bundle of nerves.
Are you afraid of him?
Mr. Benson? No.
Has he ever been violent around you?
No. Look, you're barking up the wrong tree. Mr. Benson might be a little cold, but he'd never hurt Sully.
Well, from what I'm learning, he's got an interesting past.
I just hope she's okay.
We'll find her. Sarah, listen, I'm headed toward the lake cabin.
What?
I'm following a guy who I think may have Sully.
Sully, I can't get...
Hello? Really?
Looking for something?
Hey, let's just get that one.
Let's take a look at the plan.
Hey, Charlie.
Sully better be alive.
Oh, she's alive.
Shut up, Dwayne.
Police are already looking for you. They know all about your criminal friend here.
You've got a really big mouth, Charlie.
What are you gonna do? Lock me up with Sully?
I can't afford that.
What are you gonna do?
I ain't gonna do nothing.
Well, Charles, you're right about two things. She's insane. And I'm a criminal.
No. No, please don't.
Simple words.
We did some checking up with your adoption agency to see if we could locate anyone who might know Miss Gibson.
Yes, I told you, Ellen Macy, she's the one that did the background check.
Unfortunately, we're not going to get much out of Miss Macy now. She's dead.
She's dead? She was found in her apartment. Police are still investigating.
Do you recognize this man, Mrs. Benson?
No, should I?
He was spotted with Miss Joni Mathers by a friend of yours, Charlie Holmes. His name is Dwayne Tisdale. He's wanted in Texas in connection with two murders down there.
What does that have to do with Bridget, Joni?
Not sure yet. Do you know where your husband is, Mrs. Benson?
He's out looking for her. We had a fight.
Well, in light of what you told me about him and Joni, is it possible that they're together right now?
Are you sure this is a good idea?
You want your money, don't you?
I mean, what if we just call the dad and...
It has to be this way.
Yeah, but they're looking for you.
Are you feeling better, sweetie?
I don't feel good.
I know. Well, I'm gonna go rent us a boat so that we can get out on the lake, okay?
I think I need my medicine.
And we're gonna get some for you real soon. But you need to eat some candy first. It's gonna help you feel so much better. Dwayne, candy. All right, just a few bites. And then maybe you can try and sleep while I go rent us a boat. Dwayne will be here the whole time.
Your daddy won't let me go on boats.
Just because your dad is scared of the water doesn't mean you and I can't go for boat rides. Maybe when you're older, I'll even let you drive. But right now, I need you to rest, okay, sweetie?
Hey.
What now, Dwayne?
Hold up. Come here. What was that all about back there, huh? What, boat rides?
What?
You're not keeping the kid.
Obviously. I was just trying to make her feel good. You're a paranoid son of a bitch.
Hey, don't walk away from me when I'm talking to you. Come here. You better not be messing around with me. I'm in this for the money and nothing else.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna get you your money and my money. You stay here with the girl and you try and stay out of sight this time, okay?
Okay.
I'm closing.
Please. I'll only be an hour.
Okay. Paddleboard or canoe, what kind?
I saw that you guys had outboards out there.
You know how to run them?
Much is it?
50. Going fishing?
Here's 50. Hello, Sarah. Bridget, what have you done with Sully? Please. She's okay.
you're not pregnant?
No, I never was. Don't worry about Sally. She's fine. She's safe.
Bridget, please, please tell me where she is.
You're never gonna see her again. I'm her new mom now. Robert and I are gonna take her away.
Robert's with you?
Mm-hmm. He'll be here soon.
Oh, yeah. Do you know how crazy this sounds?
Don't call me crazy.
Bridget, wait. Please.
Shut up! You are pathetic. The second I met you, I knew I didn't like you. You're stupid fruit stand with organic vegetables.
Bridget, please.
My name's Joni, by the way. You need to know something, Sarah. Robert doesn't love you. He told me so. He blames you for the accident. And he loves me.
Why take Sully? What does she have to do with any of this?
That night, when he was making love to me, I got pregnant with his child. I carried him around for 3 months and I lost him. And then, right when I was feeling like a dirty little slut, I turn on the TV and I see your face and his daughter's face, and I didn't like that very much. I hate you for stealing him away from me. Bridget, please.
You're sick. Okay, let me help you. Give me the gun.
I already told you my name's Joni. This is perfect. Sarah is so upset about losing her baby. People are gonna think it's a suicide. Just like Charlie.
Sarah? Hello? Sarah? Sarah?
Robert.
Jeez. Bridget.
No, you can call me Joni now.
Where's Sarah?
You don't have to worry about Sarah anymore. It's fine. I have Sully.
Sarah?
No. Don't you get it? You're free. We're free to be happy.
What did you do to her?
I took care of her.
Where is she?
Robert, you're acting very strange. Don't you get it? We have everything, okay? We can start our lives together. This is what we always wanted.
What are you talking about? You know what? I'm calling the police.
You weren't happy. You told me you weren't happy. I don't understand you, okay? Don't do that! We don't have much time to get away. We have to get away.
Hello, yes. Can I speak to Sheriff Watson,
please? Put the phone down.
Oh, God.
Please don't make me shoot you again.
Oh, you're sick.
No, I'm not.
Okay, Joni. Put the gun down, right? Let's just talk about this.
You told me you didn't love her.
Tell me where Sully is. We'll forget this ever happened.
I thought this is what you wanted. I don't understand.
Just put it down, right?
Robert! No. No, what did I do? I didn't mean to.
Mm-hmm.
I gotta go. Where is she?
Hey, you got the money?
Where is Sully?
She's in the bathroom. She's not feeling too good.
Oh, damn it. I forgot her medicine. We have to clear out. Where's your gun?
It's on the table. What? Hey, you got the money?
Sully, baby girl!
Hey, what happened?
I don't feel good. I know, baby. Listen, baby. Your daddy is dead. No, but you and I are gonna be fine. No, you know, we have to go.
You screwed up, didn't you? Huh? You ain't got no money. Hey, I told you what was gonna happen if you mess with me. Now I'm taking the girl.
Let her go!
Yeah, or what? Huh? You're never gonna get any money out of this anyway. It was about him the whole time. It was about the husband. Imagine a guy like that with a crazy whore like you.
I'm warning you.
What are you gonna do, huh? What are you gonna shoot her? What are you gonna shoot me? Huh?
I said to let her go.
Yeah, I'll let her go. As soon as I get my half a million. Shot me!
Mommy is already dead. I'm your new mom now.
Sarah, breathe. Sarah, breathe. Oh, you're okay.
Robert.
Yes.
She has her baby.
I know.
And Charlie tried to tell me about the cabin.
What, across the lake?
Yeah.
Yes?
Robert, you're hurt.
I know. It's my fault. I blamed you for everything. I was wrong. I'm so sorry. I'm gonna go get her.
How?
Well, she won't drive back into town. The only other way out of Storm Lake is across Mackinac Bridge.
Robert, you can't.
Where's the girl?
Crazy bitch just took off about 15 minutes ago.
Where were they headed?
I don't know.
Call for an ambulance.
She shot me.
We have an 1141.
And she's probably gonna kill that kid.
Dwayne Tisdale, you are under arrest.
She shot me!
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be you.
It's okay. You're okay. We're gonna have your insulin in the boat, all right? It's all over. My mom is waiting for us.
You can't take her, Robert.
Joni, please. She's dying. I need to give her her medicine.
You don't think I'm a good mother. You think I'm nothing. You used me, Robert, and you're never gonna use me again. I'm taking her from you.
It's okay.
Robert! I'm gonna shoot you both! Robert!
Listen to me.
I'm scared.
I'm scared too. I need you to do something, all right?
Last chance, Robert!
Okay. I trust you.
It was a smart choice. We could have had everything. We could have had a happy life together. You're a selfish coward and a liar, just like the rest of them. Come on, let's get out of here. Come here. Baby, come.
Thank you.
sure loves that bike. I told her she could ride into town tomorrow.
Look at you, not a care in the world.
She can't be a baby forever. At some point, you just have to trust her.
That is very wise. Some good parenting.
How did I get so lucky?
Luck had nothing to do with it.
Well, whatever it was, I love this song. Mary.